What is going on, guys? Rodney here with Crypto Bros. Welcome to tonight's video. Tonight, we are talking about the gig economy, a $2 trillion industry, and this blockchain-based project built specifically for the gig economy. And it is called Gig9. And essentially, what Gig9 is, it's a decentralized freelancer ecosystem that is highly focused on like local communities. So within your little like sector of the world, in your city, in your town, basically using this platform, not only can you post things that you would need done, like some type of job, like if I needed someone to come over here and mow my lawn or wash my dogs or something, I could post that out there to see if someone would be willing to do that. But at the same time, I could also post my own skills, you know, I could post that, hey, I'll make a goofy cryptocurrency video for you and post it up there and see if someone would hire me for that type of gig. So that's kind of like the overarching goal, the project here for Gig9. And while I think from a conceptual and early adopter standpoint sounds very ambitious, I think the way that this kind of world is shifting, especially when we look at like how large the gig economy is, like this has potential. And what I enjoyed about going through kind of all of their stuff here is that they kind of understand the same thing. Their roadmap and on their white paper is very long and drawn out. You know, their initial goal is to kind of get this service in 20 major cities, and I believe it's by 2020. We will dive into this website, this review, here in just a few minutes. Before we do, though, I just wanted to shout out to everyone who's been subscribing to the channel. I definitely appreciate all the likes, all the comments, all the love. You guys keep me very humble. This is why I continue to come back and do this. So just thank you for that. That being said, let's talk about Gig9. So again, as we can see, the world's first blockchain-based skill-sharing platform empowering local communities. So this is built on smart contracts, so it does have that going for it. And then the one thing that we'll kind of see here is that it says Gig9 was started by a group of multinational executives from around the world who met and honed in their skills at the Oxford FinTech program from the Oxford University. If you don't know what Oxford University is, don't worry, I quick Googled it for you. The University of Oxford is a collegiate research university located in Oxford, England. So this is on the other side of the pond. I believe they're based in London. I thought I read that in there. But anyway, not super important in that regard. Yes, this is a ongoing and current ICO. They are raising their funds. And we'll get down into token economics here in just a few minutes. I believe it's 37,000 ETH hard cap and maybe only like 3,000 soft cap. So they might be at that point right now. I can't really do this math, but hey, let's talk about what they have going on. So the very first thing that we kind of check out here on their website is kind of this push. These are some of the shows they've been at, some of the things that they've been working on, really to just push their name out there. You know, the tough part about being an ICO, I think these days, is that unless you're some type of like crazy infrastructure, it's really hard to gain some traction because of the amount of ICOs that are hitting. Like everything is being converted into a blockchain, you know, ICO, blockchain project, put everything on the blockchain ordeal. But these guys have been working pretty hard to get their name out there. They attended this is the business show 2018. This is like one of the largest like business ventures that goes on in London, and I believe they were the only blockchain project there. They went to the London Cryptocurrency Show, Blockchain Expo 2018. So they're very involved in the community and trying to push, you know, their name out there, trying to get some traction going within the community, because the tough part is, you know, when you're competing against all these other projects, right, everything looks good, you know, from the get-go. But when you're lost in a sea of all these other ones, it's very hard to gain some traction. So kudos to them. You know, we'll check out their social media and stuff. They do have some good things going on here. But as we continue to work our way through the site, here's just like the basic outline of their, you know, of what they're trying to do. And we can't really see this very well. It's fairly small, but it says, do you need something done? It doesn't matter if it's either technical or simple, whether that's grocery delivery, picking up your laundry, you need medical advice, legal advice, plumbing, whatever. You can find all this on the app. You go to the Gig9 app, you put in your need. within their kind of like, this is where it's very similar to Uber. They've got like that geolocation tracking thing that's going on. They're also incorporating like an artificial intelligence piece and a machine learning piece into this platform. And I believe that's launching in the next month. So anyway, you can track them down through the app, and it's saying the opportunities are endless, whether you need something done or you're providing your own service for whatever. And we'll see kind of as we dive into this, really they're all about taking out the middleman, you know, providing some type of like financial stability to people who can provide these type of services. But also helping out the person who needs the service by taking out that middleman, saving them some money, making sure prices are fair. So very interesting overall concept there. You know, standing back on that again, sounds very, oh, and actually we can see right here, GPS, blockchain, artificial intelligence, machine learning. But what I was going to say, you know, very techy, futuristic almost, but I think in time and with adoption, not necessarily of just blockchain, but within the gig economy, we will see projects like this, you know, adapt and move forward. I bet, you know, back in maybe 2000, I don't know when Uber's like idea was thought up, but I bet that seemed pretty weird about, oh, you just get in your car and you can go pick up other people and bring them to a location and get paid for it, and it's all on your cell phone. So I'm trying to look at it from that standpoint in terms of this. So it's bringing, you know, that, you know, ride sharing service, but it's bringing it to all kinds of different services that can be provided. And they're very, you know, they don't discriminate against them. So I think that's pretty cool. So anyway, as we get in here, again, you'll see their underlying theme is they really want to bring this to local communities. And it says connecting local communities in terms of sharing skills and lending hands, opportunities for everyone by everyone. Location-based service, Gig9 provides a personal touch, allowing jobs to get done locally, verified transactions, payments, and reviews, automated payments without middlemen, track service providers through Gig's provider navigation system, no sign-up fees, membership fees, or advertising costs. And I actually think this one is really important right here, is this set says escrow service powered by smart contracts. So, you know, if you're doing a crypto-to-crypto, you know, if I needed my lawn mowed, and someone's willing to accept the cryptocurrency, my money wouldn't, you know, I would, you know, push it out there, whatever. I'm not quite paying them, but my money that I'm paying for their service goes into an escrow account. Once the actual job is completed, it moves out of the escrow account into the service provider's account. And I think that's a very interesting concept in that it just kind of keeps things fluid and safe. But also one thing to note here is you can pay for a service, like again, back to my crappy lawn mowing example, I can pay for that in cash. It doesn't have to be, you know, on this Gig9 platform, or it doesn't have to be with the Gig9 token. I can choose, you know, if I had $30 around, I can choose to pay for my lawn mowing service in cash. So I think the flexibility there really helps kind of move along the adoption piece of their kind of overarching goal. And the last thing they're pointing out here is equal opportunities. And it doesn't matter of your gender, your age, your physical ability, whatever. It's just putting it all out there so anybody can work, do, provide a service, all out there. So again, very cool general concept. Again, somewhat futuristic, but give it time and we'll see if stuff like this catches on. Me personally, I don't know if Gig is the one to do that, but I think we'll see this whole movement continue to grow, especially when we're talking about like the millennial generation coming up. But so far, liking what I see. In this aspect, it just talks about, you know, the use cases for their actual Gig token. You know, it's designed to grow with the Gig9 business. The higher demand, the more use cases for the token, the stronger the token value gets. It's tangible and liquid, meaning you can, you know, quickly exchange it for Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, and it's backed by real jobs performed. Gig9's coin value will rise as the number of jobs completed and grow. So the more coins they're getting out there in circulation, basically the better impact it will have on you know, the price of the single token. So anyway, when we're breaking it down into just their core features and what they've kind of laid out, again, we talked about the smart contracts. They have their own token. It is peer-to-peer, digital wallet. They're saying it's cost-effective, making a trustment payment system through that escrow account, GPS mapping. We kind of covered some of these things. Again, when it breaks down into this, you know, very similar to the features up here, but this kind of breaks it down a little bit, saying, look, pretty easy concept to grasp. Gig economy is growing. We're incorporating smart contracts and blockchain. This is the next wave of, you know, earning some type of income and getting tasks accomplished. This part, as we get down into this, is just really their token allocation, their token economics, if you will. What I found really interesting, 82% of all their tokens are going out during the token sale, and their total supply is only 268 million coins. So, you know, relative to some of these other newer projects where we're seeing a billion, you know, multi-billion tokens, this is still fairly low circulating supply. So from like a, maybe an ROI standpoint, out of the gates, if this gains some traction and they do hit their, you know, their goals, get on the exchanges, especially some ones that have some visibility, that could be a very good thing, you know, for a longer term investment, whether you're using the platform or not, or just simply looking at it as an ROI standpoint. And again, token hard cap, 37,000 ETH, soft cap only 3,000 ETH. So that is fairly doable. I didn't do this math up there. I think Ethereum is under $600 at this point. Markets are down today. It is May, I don't know what the date is today, sorry. It is May 23rd. So yeah, we've kind of seen this big pullback. But anyway, moving on. The team. What I like about this team and what they're very proud of is these are eight, you know, Oxford alumni graduates. And if you check out their LinkedIn, all of them have, you know, specific set of skills that kind of tie into this program. And they basically, they have experience under their belt in a vast array of things. What I also like about this is the fact that this is a, you know, I always say the team is speculative, right? But what I like about it is there's a lot of people here. You know, it's more than four people working on this pretty massive project. So again, going down to the executive team, here we have nine folks and then a group of advisors. You guys can check this out. Again, a lot of these people, if you check out their LinkedIn pages, they have something that would pertain and make them of some value in this. I'm not necessarily going to go through and say, this is an all-star, this is not an all-star, but you can just kind of see. We've got some blockchain advisors, fintech advisors, administrative people, ICO legal counsel, developers, like the vast array. I think the more projects that come into play, the less all-star teams we will see. So anyway, let's check out their, really I want to get into their, oh here. If you guys haven't, you can go onto their website. We're just going to scroll to the top here really fast. Sorry about that. They do have a lot of documents you can check out. You know, if we hit the roadmap, I'm going to check out the roadmap on their one pager because I think that's pretty cool. But you can check out this. That I thought for a roadmap, it was pretty realistic, you know, in terms of adoption, getting people on there, where they're going. We'll look at that in a minute. Also, you can check out their company certificate, contribution manual. So if someone wanted to participate, there's instructions on how to do that. Their technical paper, financial paper, and their white paper. One thing to note is they have it in a bunch of different languages. We're going to check out the English version. They do have this airdrop deal. I didn't look at into this, what it is. You know, I'm not really a big fan of airdrops of any kind. And I know a lot of people crush it on the airdrop thing. That's just not my style. So anyway, let's take a look. One, we're just going to do a quick glance at their white paper. And the reason I'm bringing over here is just because I want to share the amount of essentially like services you can provide. So it's like accounting, administrative, advertising, painting, babysitting, business consultant, personal trainer, electrician, engineer. Whatever type of need you can probably think of, like you can put that out there. You can make a request for somebody's help. And what I think is really, really important to note is that you're not getting some like random person that's showing up. Much like Uber, you'll actually be able to see like, you know, who the person is, how many jobs they've completed, their score, right? So if you're on the Uber app and you get a driver, it's like, oh, they've done 3,000 trips. Their average rank is a 4.9. They have some excellent reviews. This is going to be very similar process where you can kind of self-vet these people before they come over into your house and start plumbing or doing photography or shopping for you or picking up your groceries or folding your laundry or whatever it is. So I think that part is important. So you just understand, like, there is some safety involved in here. It's not like any Joe Schmo. I mean, they can. I guess any Joe Schmo can show up on the app. But, you know, that's one thing to consider. At least with the, you know, the Uber application, there is a vetting project. There is a vetting process. You have to meet specific requirements, you know, with your car and stuff. And this will follow that same suit. So anyway, onto the white page, onto the one pager. Yeah, this isn't the most efficient, but it works. And it's a sharp one pager. Like, it breaks down everything through here. We can see exactly how the, you know, I don't think most people have a hard understanding of grasping how this would work, right? Request a service, goes through your phone, get a notification, tell them what you want, negotiate the fee, see what it is, blah, blah, blah. Pretty easy to understand. But what I do want to touch on is this. So they've been working on this for about a year now. Q2 2017 was kind of the inception of the idea. They got the team together. The end of last year, they kind of started this ICO preparation. As we move forward into Q2, you know, they're kind of doing their token launch. And really, I want to get down to when they get their stuff going. So they're in their ICO phase, Q1 into Q2, blah, blah, blah. We move along. Q2 is their token launch. This is where they're actually going to, you know, right now they're shooting to be on exchanges sometime within quarter two. Obviously, it said their date on the homepage here of when the token sale ended. That's actually not a huge ordeal in this review, but here's where things start to get interesting. This is when they're launching, you know, their technical service, and this is quarter one, 2019. Once we have overcome any beta and testing issues, which they will be working on back through here, product beta launch shall be open to the public as a beta testing period to allow us to iron out any issues that may arise. This is pretty standard protocol, pretty smart, right? Do a beta release, you know, a test net if we're talking about blockchain. But then after they kind of release that and they go to their true service launch, here's when people are actually going to be, you know, potentially using active on Gig9, and it's officially going to be launched in the UK during the first quarter of 2019, marking the official product launch of Gig9. The cool thing to note here is, like, their project and the stuff that they have going on is up and running. They've got their platform. They're doing the right things in place here. I think that their biggest issue that they're going to have to overcome is getting people to kind of get start on the app. So here's where I really like their roadmap. So they're talking Q1 is their launch, Q1 2019 is their launch, Q1 2020 they're shooting to be in 20 major cities, you know, globally. So how that works, I don't exactly know. I don't know the distribution of how they're going to work in there, but, you know, I'm assuming they're going to start somewhere over in the UK, you know, probably focus in London, getting people adopting there, and then pushing the growth. Obviously, a lot of advertisement's going to come into that, because not only do they need to get, you know, people maybe like myself that need something done, but also they're going to have to get all these different service providers on there. And one thing they break down is, I forget where this is at. They're going to be in part of this early adoption phase. They're going to be strategically working on getting people on the platform, working with service providers, working with people to get them to sign up. So they almost have like another revenue stream, right? If you're just a mechanic or something, you just have maybe a website, or you're in a phone book, they're going to be working with you specifically and attempting to get you on the platform to potentially bring you in more business. And I think that is a very key thing to note. So that's very interesting. And then again, Q2 2021, top 50 cities, and then by 2022, again, that's 4 years from now, and a lot can happen, especially as quickly as technology moves. You know, 4 year plan to get quite a few people on this platform. You know, we will see how it goes. Again, I love the idea of this. I just think adoption, when we're talking about this many people and this many things, is very tough to do. But like I said, when we're kind of reverting that to the millennial side of things and that kind of up and coming generation, I believe I'm a millennial. I don't actually know the years, but it doesn't matter. But I believe we'll kind of see this type of thing pick up. We already know the gig economy is quite large. So anyway, just checking out their social on their Telegram, basically 8,500 active users on there. That's pretty cool. I was also surprised to see how many people were on their Twitter. You know, 5,400 followers on there, and they're very active. They're posting a lot of content. Community members have uploaded an Italian one pager. You know, they're doing all types of things. They've got YouTube videos. This one's worth checking out. This is their CEO. She just kind of gives a broad overview, whatever you want to call it, of kind of like the background and where Gig9 is kind of fitting into this gig economy. And it's a pretty cool, it's a short video. So as we continue to move on, you guys know I like to check out ICO rating reviews on some of these different platforms just to see what other people are saying. I am in the US, so I will not be investing in this because of KYC, but right now, investment rating not available here on ICO rating. Hype score, they actually got a high, which is a 2.9 out of 5, and then the risk score is a medium. And then again, you know, like always, you can check out all their social stuff. They've got a lot of stuff. Website on Bitcoin Talk, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, Telegram, YouTube, Reddit, Medium, GitHub. I checked out their GitHub. Not very much activity on there, but they are working on that. So that's interesting. Last but not least, ICO Bench gave them a 3.8 out of 5. Their ICO profile got a 4.1, team 4.0, vision 3.0, and product 3.5. You guys can check all this out, you know, for a very condensed version. Like, you can check out some of these ratings or whatever, but also check out their white paper. Their videos are very good too. They're short and they give you, oh, we can see ICO expires in 52 days. But it gives you the overarching concept of what they're trying to accomplish. And again, I think most people have a good understanding of Uber, so this isn't really hard to grasp. It just seems futuristic outside of the ride-sharing place. So anyway, oh, actually I have their GitHub up. So yeah, check it out. Pretty basic. They've on there fairly new, but they do have a GitHub. They understand people are looking on that. And, you know, obviously, like I said earlier, working on the smart contract. So overall, pretty cool idea, pretty cool concept. I do think, you know, what's going to make or break them is the ability to get to, you know, push this, see this through, get people adopted on the platform. And I don't mean to sound like negative on that. You know, that's always the biggest challenge for all of these major projects is just to get the adoption piece. And I think specifically within the gig economy space, you know, whether it's these guys or someone else, I think this type of technology, this type of idea will emerge at some point in time. So anyway, guys, that is all I have for you. I'm sure this was a super long video. I feel like I've been ranting forever. But anyway, just wanted to thank you guys for tuning in. If you haven't had a chance to subscribe yet, all you gotta do is come over here, hit the subscribe button. Just know how much I appreciate each and every one of you guys, every comment, every subscription, every like. You know, without you guys and everything, I wouldn't be here. So anyway, I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Another cryptocurrency video. Stay cool. That was the worst thing I've ever said. Stay cool. Anyway, I love you guys. See ya.